This video and the PS5 gameplay couldn't have been recorded without my sponsor, Elgato. If you're looking for an amazing 4K capture card for the PS5 to record gameplay like you see in this video, check the link in the description. Ladies and gentlemen, I have the PS5 early. I can't really believe it either, but the folks over at PlayStation UK were super kind in sending me a console early, so big thank you to them. I've already uploaded a video unboxing the PS5 and showing gameplay of Spider-Man and the included game Astro's Playroom, but today we're going to be looking at backwards compatible games on PS5. And we're talking Black Ops Zombies. We're going back to Black Ops 3 and Black Ops 4 Zombies and playing them on PS5 to show you just how much better they are than PS4 Pro. We're going to be looking at the resolution, we're going to be looking at frame rate, and also loading times. And what's even crazier is Black Ops 3 Zombies Chronicles Edition is free on PS5, and it will feature a PS5 Game Boost patch, which will improve the loading times and the frame rate. This is the first video you've seen of Black Ops Zombies on the PS5. Please drop a thumbs up and support the video. I'd really, really appreciate it. If you have any requests for other games you want to see on PS5, let me know in the comment section below. So the first thing we're going to do on the PS5 is we're going to do a boot test. We're going to compare how quickly this machine can boot up the old games in comparison to the PS4 Pro, which it's very slow. So we're going to time this on your screen so you should see this happen in real time and the same time. So in 3, 2, 1, go. Now you see the PS5 is instant immediate, but when I booted it on my PS4, there was a bit of a delay. I don't know if it was because the PS4 is just that slow, but yeah, there was a big delay. And already, like, we're going through the process of booting it up and loading and stuff. The PS4 has only just started doing it. I never remember it being that slow before. Like, this is what I remember the speed being, but apparently not. The PS4, there's a PS4 Pro as well. Very slow in comparison. So even though this hasn't had its game boost patch yet, it's still really, really cool. And there we go. We're on to Black Ops 3, the main menu. There we go. So I think we need to start testing some zombies maps. So the real test begins in how quickly we can get into the game. So we'll start off with Shadows of Evil, and we're going to time these exactly the same. So 3, 2, 1. All right, here we go. The race is on. Now, unfortunately, I'm going to have to blur the cutscene because it is copyright, but you guys know the gist when it comes to this cutscene. You're listening for the hey you. And I'm going to be just spamming away at the skip button to see. There we go. We've already gotten through, while the PS4 Pro, we've still got another, like, I don't know, 20, 30 seconds of that to go. Now, what makes this really interesting is the PS4 Pro version of Black Ops 3 got a pro patch update back in 2016, which added full 4K support for Black Ops 3. So if you play this on Xbox Series X, you're not going to be getting that 4K upgrade in terms of the visual quality than on PlayStation. Well, I don't know if it's even noticeable, but stuff like the round number, just the way that the font looks, it looks so much crisper and clearer than it did on, you know, every other console. So straight away, without that PS5 Game Boost patch being out yet for this game, you can see a significantly quicker load time, which is amazing. Now, another thing on the PS4 and the PS4 Pro is that there is, like, texture pop-in. So you go to certain parts of the maps and, you know, textures haven't fully loaded in yet. And what the game does is it loads, like, a normal version of the texture while it's trying to load in the higher quality one. But here, I don't see anything like popping in or loading in slowly. Like, going up to like posters like this, for example, you'd really notice it, but the detail is there. Even things like this as well. Just things that the game doesn't need to load in very quickly. So when it comes to like playing like the legacy zombies like this, this is the smoothest, best looking version of this on a console you will find. And what makes this even more interesting is that PS4 Pro's patch for Black Ops 3 obviously made it look way better with a 4K resolution, but that was a checkerboarded 4K. Depending on what you were playing on the game, like campaign, it changed resolution a lot. And obviously it wasn't straight 4K native resolution, but there's no doubt in my mind that with this game being 5 years old, what we're looking at with zombies is a full 4K experience. And it definitely will be come the time we get that PS5 game boost patch. I think it's fair that we look at the most demanding zombies map on this game, bar none, which is Gorod Krovi. We spoke about it in the Xbox Series X video when it comes to the frame drops, and just there's so much going on in that map. So let's see how quick we can get into that. Okay, we're gonna time these perfectly. So 3, 2, 1, boom. As you can see, even the cutscene loaded in way quicker than it did on the PS4 Pro. Now, I will admit, if you guys watched the Series X video, you'll know that the cutscene was skippable so quick. Like, right there, we could skip. And it doesn't seem to be as quick this time around. It's really odd. It seems specific zombie maps will load quicker than others, and this is just one of them. So, okay, there we go. Took a little while, honestly. It took a little while. Also got to take into account the 4K textures that this is loading in compared to the Xbox version. But yeah, this map's notorious for just having frame drops galore, the textures being super slow to load in. But I gotta say, everything in the spawn room is incredibly detailed straight off the bat. And we only just loaded up on the PS4 Pro. Like, it is insane. I play this game so much on PC, I've never really noticed the loading times being a long time. What's mad about the PS5 is you can see how long you've played certain games for. And I've put nearly 1,500 hours into this game on PS4 alone. Not even counting the PC version. Let's see, texture stream right here. Oh, there you go. It was loaded in instant. It was loaded in instantly. Man, the gap between Xbox and PS5 is so slim. Literally, the only thing that lets the PS5 down is not being able to play Black Ops 2 or Black Ops 1. And World at War, for that matter. That's something that Series X is insanely good. The fact that we can play all of those under one box, that's next gen. And you have the quick resume feature as well, which sadly the PS5 doesn't have. I was very, very surprised by that. It's like stuff like this, like the dragon flying over right here. Like, you get frame drops like crazy. Okay, let's try Origins. I'm so excited to see how the PS5 can handle this gargantuan map. So we're going to boot it up at the same time. So 3, 2, 1. Let's see. Strangely, this doesn't actually take as long to load and get into as you would expect, but we'll see how quickly we can skip this cutscene. Okay, there we go. So we got the skip about there, and we also got it about the same on the PS4 Pro, so not a huge increase. And whoa, okay, the light from that was blinding, but we did get into the game a fair bit quicker than we did on the PS4 Pro. Whoa, that was so weird. We need to jump to Black Ops 4 because, man, if you thought the loading was bad on this game, Black Ops 4 has some of the worst loading times I've seen ever in a COD game. Let's do a quick boot up test. So 3, 2, 1, go. As you can see, boom, Black Ops 4 was like, boom, straight away into that splash screen. You might experience unexpected game behavior when playing this PS4 game on a PS5 console. Okay, very weird. This is like one of those games that's like, it is compatible, but there could be a few problems here and there. But my God, just look how quicker it got into this compared to the PS4 Pro. It's insane. All right, let's connect to online service. Now, Black Ops 4 Zombies is notorious having just the longest loading screens ever. So let's see how this deals. Ready up. Now, you can see we've got them neck and neck here. So this should be really interesting.
Give us the fire.
And instantly we're into the cutscene.
Do not speak,
and you'll notice we're into the cutscene a little quicker than the PS4 Pro. But it's interesting to see how quickly we can skip this. Will we actually make it into Alcatraz? Okay, he's ripping down the poster. No! Boom! We didn't even get into Alcatraz in the cutscene and we're already there. Now, the Black Ops 4 spinny logo thing is also very important to see just how long it will take, because this thing, I feel like I've stared at it for a good chunk of my life at this point. Okay, that really wasn't that bad. That wasn't that bad at all, you know? And PS4 Pro is still going with that cutscene. It is still going. What the heck? Now, I know when you play like multiplayer games on Black Ops 4 Zombies, you can, you know, sit in the lobby for a bit before you boot up and it starts like pre-allocating data. And I reckon that would do this. And I reckon it'd be a lot faster on PS4 Pro as well than this. And look at that. The cutscene's only just loaded. Like, that is a joke. Let's go ahead and check out 9, because that map also feels like it takes ages to load. Okay, here we go with 9. Let's get them synced up. There we go. Another perfect synchronization. So, yeah. On PS4, this took ages. So hopefully we see an improvement. If we can skip before we actually go and do the hallucination bit, that's a win in my book. Oh my God. What? I was not expecting it to be that quick. That was really quick. Okay. How long are we going to see that spinning logo though in the bottom right? Come on. I know you can do it, PS4 Pro. NVMe SSD is doing bits for these old games right now. Come on. There we go. That was so quick that that hadn't even lowered up fully enough. That's crazy. You don't really see that unless you're on a PC. That's really funny to me. That's really entertaining. But I think the true test is Voyage of Despair, because there's just so much going on all the time in that map. It's not a surprise that the PS4 Pro sometimes has like FPS drops and stuff, because it's just insane. But there we go. The cutscene's only just finished on PS4. Only just finished. Okay, let's sync them up. Ready up and boom. Okay, now this will be really interesting, because on the PS4 Pro, it lagged so hard that the cutscene like had to speed up to catch up to where it didn't play at. Like, you could hear it, but you couldn't see it. You'll see that. That was a bit too quick. That was insanely quick. That's the fastest one yet, considering how big this map is. That is insane. All right. Let's see how it does here, because, you know, it starts off with the massive iceberg coming in. Which is just ridiculous in itself. But as you can see, the game is not breaking a sweat. It's not breaking a sweat. I didn't see a single FPS drop. It looks pretty good to me. This looks really damn good. It's super, super impressive. When you look at the PS4 Pro version, we're still going in that cutscene. I couldn't ever imagine playing a version of it that slow again. It really makes you just appreciate how quick games load now. Like, we'll get to a point where we don't even think about it. They just load. It's very clear that Black Ops 4 and especially Voyage of Despair pushed the hardware to the absolute limit. And it's really interesting looking at a direct comparison of this game on like Xbox One X, for example. How crisp and clear the resolution was on that game compared to the Pro. It definitely wasn't 4K on the Pro. But here, it's looking very crisp, even though we've not had a patch. I can't say for certain if this is 4K native or not. I don't think it would be without a patch, but it looks really damn good nonetheless. Now, before we round this video up, I've got one final fun test on Black Ops 4, which I don't think you guys will expect, but it's going to be a huge, drastic surprise in how quick the PS5 will boot it in comparison to PS4. Now, you're probably going, what the heck, John? What is this? Well, this is Blackout, ladies and gentlemen. One of the most ambitious things that Treyarch has ever done until we see Cold War. And it'd be really interesting to see how quick this loads in comparison to how quickly it loaded on PS4 Pro, which is obviously really slow. You can see the blue bar indicates how quickly it's loading everything in. We're nearly done here, while the PS4 Pro was only a quarter of the way done at this point. It's insane how big this map is and just how much there is to load in. And poor PS4 Pros and even slower PS4s had to deal with this for the entire year that this game was the main game. As you can see, we're in. It's looking fantastic. And the PS4 is still loading. It's still loading, ladies and gentlemen. How nuts is that? It's not done yet. And it's only just finished. It's only just finished. Now, when it comes to like texture streaming on games, this is probably the one where we're going to notice a massive difference on the next-gen consoles. Not like most of you guys are going to play Blackout anyway. This is the most recent Treyarch game, so it's a pretty good indication of what Cold War's performance is going to be like going across from PS4 and PS5. But something I'm really interested to test is how it does once we deploy, because I tested this on PS4 Pro, and you'll see this in the video that the actual like helicopters flying when we go in deploying on the plane, there was a physical frame drop. Like, the FPS dipped to like, I don't know, it looked like 20 to 30. It looked really bad. So I'm interested to see if the PS5 completely negates that or not, and if we can actually get in quicker. So here we go. This is the ultimate test, ladies and gentlemen, to finish out this video. As you can see, oh, it's smooth. Oh, it's smooth. You see how rough it was? How rough that was on the Pro? I didn't see a single frame drop here. Not one single drop, which is very, very impressive. And obviously, this is old technology now. With Warzone, it's so much more optimized for the old consoles. So it's going to be very interesting to see how Warzone plays if they do decide to change anything about it for next gen and optimize it on that end. But straight away, it's so clear to see just how much better playing these old games are on PS5, and I'm so happy that the PS5 has a backwards compatibility feature like the Xbox Series X. Massive thank you again to PlayStation UK for sending me the PlayStation 5 early. If you told me like 7 years ago when the PS4 came out that I'd be getting the next generation of console early, I wouldn't have believed you, and I'm just absolutely gobsmacked that I have this and the Xbox Series X so early before release. It's an absolute blessing, so I can't thank you guys enough for the support that allowed that to happen. Plenty more PS5 videos coming very, very soon to the channel, so be sure to subscribe so you don't miss out on that, and be sure to like this video as well. You can catch another video on your screen right now, but I'll catch you for another video very soon.